problems there. And
damn,
even have the finger death or a scrim or something like that. It's very possible to see that hero down and hurt. Who knows? We seen don't pull back from old. How did he change this much mana? Mostly teleported up here, but he must have left down that. So he's down a little bit of mana. Straight pick with the Elder Titan. Oh no, darn again, guys. Panic. Versus the old. It does have more damage to bump. It looks like that'll be about a tie, so there's that. But you know, they do now have this void here. May be able to deal with observer placed at us. It really shouldn't be surprising this time. Seeing a new kind of home.
30 seconds.
Got
to
old chicken toy top line off. Off lane, of course. See what they're able to do elsewhere. Again, mid lane is usually one of the more consistent ones, but in a half-a-run, it's always going to be a little bit tricky. Damage is pitiful to say.
The battle begins.
So, ultimately, the traps. Not guaranteed. First damage is honestly pretty thick as well. Not sure to the tier side. Chain keep somehow dodged every hour. Make sure that it doesn't hit it with any the guard that even needed to apply pressure get to for any support over in. I don't expect that to really be the case if land are the and out of course depends on what creeps he finds fast he's to level up in the jungle, because the first level of Doom can really be in hero. Something by don't count that supposed to work by that. Big angle sort of setup, and it works occasionally. And suddenly, take all that much damage for old Shaky Oak. Perfect world. It's dark, guys. I am going to try to connect one time, so to avoid it. But that's the part that due to waste is have to be as well. And if I go set up, here we go. We'll see if it's able to hold. Well, it doesn't seem like we missed anything, so it's all good. We got rid of the top. Looks like he's gonna have a pretty good time here. But the board is gonna be difficult to actually get on top of it's the old weapon. Tipping up that like penalty up. Doom maybe try to get towards and grab a little here. Expect that to be happening. In the meantime, bottom lane, I'm taking an absolute ton of damage. Is going to be getting blood. Level 2, 3 arrow, 1 straight. Min maxing this Kling for sure. Usually it's going to be get skeleton lock. You never know when you're going to get ganked, but honestly, you kind of do know when you're going to get ganked up against EC. There's a little bit more of an build. Crystal Mage. Level 2, not quite that arcane, but we'll see here eventually. Significant aids to honestly the links called Doom. But he's that is tipping out a little bit as well. Some extra Starstorm cast for and given that little bit of an edge versus Timbersaw, which he's gonna need a little bit of. See double stars. Do quite a bit of work towards Super, but Super does not give a damn 10 armor for their reactions. One as well. Or chicken is always nice. More map of nice as well. So the Crystal Maiden, as long as she's able to get the kill participations, survive to go into the jungle. No pressure here. In fact, Isaac is applying pressure. The 4 stacks of napalm will grow to a halt. Middle still able to jump. So, and look, may have to start looking towards the jungle a little bit. He's going to look to gain a lot in this game. This rotation of the Stasis Void out Doom in is actually pretty reasonable. Then right now doesn't have a ton. And you don't really need a lot of Void that you kind of do. Yeah, at all the same time. Whereas Doom, you would like to burst him down as well, but just the raw health difference. Get two more stay on this plan. Guy save Devour and move enough to close in and harass back.
Haste!
I don't know what you guys are saying. I hope that everything's fine. It's not, you have to be more direct. They're gonna try to go for the old Doom. Pump, Chainsaw is good. Link Q get in, he's level 2, Spike there. Old Levin's going to ride and see him land without having his regeneration up. Doesn't matter how much damage gets there. Probably, but this is kind of what you have to spend here. You need very high damage points if you're gonna use on someone like Doom. And the damage from Sick is quite high, but not high enough. Well, now that Earth is up on Doom, odds of getting a kill are extremely, extremely low. So Dizzy Home having that nice little one kill lead. Also Super though, doing some pretty work versus Old Chicken. Got the Chakram, level 1 tier chain as well. Pretty much all you need up against the Crystal Maiden Doom potential roam. Chakram. Damage adds very quickly on a Mirage. Not exactly a hero. You see, Doom rotating in, looks like there's gonna be bomb refills. Where it's almost bone slime. Same thing can be said from Isis Ice down to another Lightstone already. Love that Lightstone pickup. I really hate it when Clinks is like planned to go for Deso and then don't get a Blightstone until super late. It does so much extra damage for the hero and for structures as well, which is kind of a unique effect among heroes. Yeah, he's just chipping away and he doesn't really have to worry about all that much. He even gets straight power down. And this damage is adding up. Ice pushing it at about the same clip as a Terror Blade, which is no small feat to say the least. Now, this is shoving the wave consistently into the tower, so Yao, he is able to get quite a lot of experience by hugging the tower. And I'm sure you don't get too close to a Crystal Maiden to hit with any of your spells. You should be getting experience as a Batrider, but you know, gold, not really sure if that's necessarily in the cards for the Bat until he's gonna decide to go into the jungle. And we can see his jungle is sparse to say the least. Is this stacked up anywhere? We've got a couple Ancients being created, of course, for the Sven down the line, but it seems like the Batrider's income, money-wise, is not going to be incredible in this game. His lane control up against Clinks, really any hero's lane control up against Clinks is gonna be strained to say the least. And now he's in a little bit more trouble. Searing arrows to the back. Ice consuming his anger there. He's looking deeper. Yao, Observer Ward is going to give him a little bit of vision, but not quite enough. That's Windlace Tranquil Boot value right there. Old Chicken could have taken the arrow shot of destiny, but decided not to. What a coward. Throw the arrow. You got Arcane Rune and Arcane Ultra. So double cane. No downside there, but yeah, whatever. It's all good, man. The Batrider out of line. Let Ice do Clink's things versus the tower, and already we have Ehome at a little bit of a nerf lead because of the first blood, because of tower destruction, and they also can have Ice just stay here forever. Keep shoving on the bottom lane, keep applying pressure on the Batrider, keep trying kills, even the kills may not be out there. Isn't really that much downside. Even with the rotation of the Marana into the lane, the jungle with and a little bit of time pass. Usually it's going to happen where the Clinks rotates out, giving so support, in this case Doom, the free lane to get some farm. Clinks is applying the pressure, so he can still roam out, give the bottom lane to anyone else, but it's a bit too far. So getting level Doom is going to Kamen's mid, which is potentially more difficult, especially when Super goes in deep. Chakram's on the ground, and they'll chase after the Doom, but Scorch again be the undoing Super. That's crazy. But there is enough chicken driving for Star off the team. I think it goes off the key by itself. Oh, baby. Yeah, this plan is looking like it's matches so far from CDC. And Ehome are doing two CDC. What CDC is on down all of them dominated it. And just pretty much that advantage till the end of the game. Sorry about that lag, guys. The Perfect World sometimes is going to strike without you noticing, without you realizing. Doom involved that M as well. Crystal Maiden. There's a real game where Crystal Maiden really becomes a lot stronger. Like the Doom 6. Every single level makes M so much more valuable to the team. Doom is just decided that. It's instead going to go with more Frostbite. A little bit more setup duration. Leaf Arrow. Usually I like Frostbite. With the Nova, if you're going to go more damage heavy, or just, you know, straight or. For the pure person. Oh, lag. You see what I happen. We're in a to queue right now. The Nova, right level 2, 11 though, spiked up, so the he's not quite there. The arrow's all gonna miss. Somehow got into the fight, being viewer as well. Hughes was still on the run by 2 here. 4, talk board, and open, grab the kill at the same exact time. Much like before, it's going to be another kill as the Timbersaw, I assume the Doom, yes, takes the Doom base with Ice's damage output. Ehome 5 in the lead over C-Deck. The only thing that Ehome are not doing fantastically right now is keeping tabs on the Sven. He is still getting some amount of farm, and he will have an opportunity to get even more farm clearing this ancient. So, and even though he may be behind on some of their other heroes, yes, that is bad. Rabbit is pretty much where he wants to be, where pretty much Sven wants to be. At 10 minutes, he has had a free lane of farm, and he is going to clear out a pretty massive stack of ancients as well. Oh baby, look at the gold. So yes, Sven's happy. No one else is going to be happy in this game, however. Ehome running pretty aggressively with their clinks. Late at this point, Decimator. Hammers should be coming up soon, and Fenrir's getting the experience, as is Doom. Everyone's assets are coming from this phase, and sooner or later, old is going to start looking for those Aghanim Scepter components. You know, points to right now would be pretty good for her. 11, and he's got the Vanguard. Going to get a bulk on this phase, boy. Knowing that he only has to survive as it stands right now, Ron eventually will be doing damage. I'm not sure if it's necessarily built, but usually, like, their option. You're not gonna like rush Blink Dagger. You're gonna go from the Vlad style, which is okay versus C deck, but not necessarily amazing until a little bit later on when Natural Order gets leveled up. Blitz gets a lot better. Yeah, fine this pick. I think it's fine for the Fade Void. I would like to see it use laid on someone from most likely. I mean, someone can get Diffusal Blade here, but as far as getting it quickly, I don't think it's really a card for anyone. They're fine with way too late. Getting rid of Sven. So, Q. Hex and run away. Spike, slow down, Blink, not gonna do it. No, here comes the little chicken with a haste through. Guys are gonna fall on the lion. And that'll get a very easy, albeit laggy kill on the lion. 6-0 for Ehome and Tower with the Blightstone. The level 3 Searing Arrows is probably gonna fall mostly because C-Deck don't wanna make a defense. And what are they doing in the meantime? Honestly, not much. Rabbit's farming up the jungle. Echo Saber should be coming up soon for him. He's got up about halfway towards that item. And see that they are almost at their Blink Dagger. Yeah, I was able to freeze the lane in this general area. Pretty sick area for Batrider to farm. Once they get the Blink Dagger, they'll be able to at least look for their first kill. But right now, it's Ehome slowly collapsing on the map from C-Deck. It's getting worse once the axe come up on the Mirana. Damming out that Starstorm every wave of creep she finds. Suddenly becomes very Brewmother-esque. C-Deck will have to go for her with the Barrier almost exclusively. Hopefully for them though, get line enough gold, give me some initiation of his own to get the level to get the blink. so that they can actually follow up with the Batrider and instantly kill off Murata. But for right now, Moonlight Shadow Lion is going to be spotting this out. Like it's going to end up with two, but doesn't hit on the face's point, which doesn't step forward. Serious double here, but they're going to not use it. Little Starstorm, and that will kill off Crystal Maiden. Somehow killing that kill, but 72 deaths. There's no aggressive power to like, see that spot after yet playing very, very passive. Armlet? Dude, jeez. Hold on. That's an aggressive high need to build a button on. I'm not sure if this is the aura build on Doom. I'm inclined to say no. Because you're a hero and you're going to try to get sent or a timber. I don't really think that's the best plan. Got to be pretty reasonable here, but I'm just looking at right click thing. Is, I guess, kind of nice. As it seems like it's a little bit of a greedy, aggressive selection, which you could do as well in these infights just by making sure everyone stays alive, because then everyone else is doing the damage. Oh well, what's done is done. We'll see what he's able to do with this. And we'll see what old 11 wants to go for next as well. I like the Diffusal Blade here, but who knows? E-Home, they kind of do their own thing. You never know what's going on in the E-Home camp until they kind of kill you with it. E-Home, they have the Desolator on the Klinks, the Chronosphere up on the Void. CDEC, they are scared crapless. They're gonna smoke up, try to get the surprise with the Blink Dagger, although I think this Observe Ward from the Radiant might have spotted. They're going to blow the smoke. Old 11's gonna take the lasso. Frostbite for Premier, not gonna be there. Old 11 in a lot of trouble with the hammer. With the stomp, they'll kill up Faceless Void and also catch Fenrir. This poor Crystal Maiden is going to tarnish the flawless score. One shot, two shot, and there's a Timber Chain kill. Now Yao jumping forward, looking for Lana, but Ice Knight can deal with the damage, and with the Starstorm, they'll kill out the Batrider. Overconfidence from Yao, Old Chicken now, gonna chuck the arrow. I don't know where it went, but it's somehow connected onto Q. Ice now really able to last it in. Stomp is there, but it's too late to save the Lion. A 2-for-2 exchange after all is said and done. Earth Splitter, did that hit anyone? I don't know. Please, Perfect World, please stop. Either way, it's a relatively even trade going back and forth. The big asset here for E-Home is that they do still have their Chronosphere, and they don't have to worry about a lasso for a little while longer. Not the largest cooldown of the spell. They also do have to expend the Doom, but there were lots of ultimates expend there by the C-Deck squad. Whereas for E-Home, they still can land a Chronosphere and win a fight out of nowhere. Hey, look at that. Death Pact Room Service for Ice. Now, this is incredibly risky for E-Home. Even though they do have this armlet on Doom, the minus armor and physical damage from the Klinks, you're doing this up against a Batrider with a Link. You're doing a very easy spam, Rock Room into the pit, and of course, an infinite scout out that. Oh, and three shots. I don't know if there's any support, but Lion 9 network is not going to have any infinite skill on. Blue line. Luck, man. You're gonna need to win a team fight. Survive it if you want that. That one pickoff, and they're gonna try to go into Roche afterwards. Or will they? No, it's gonna be. Yeah, them rushing that Roche to that on anyone, I don't know. Or will they end one? Yeah, matter because they have a. Ooh, actually, like, on the taking out all these towers with a shadow on base. No one can really any hero. One. Nothing comes to mind, but you know, I'm not gonna rack my brain right now thinking of it. What this does is allow them to use the fact that you know all the towers. Like right now, this is something that you cannot gank. The tower is still funny. They have shadow blitz. Since you will have all the towers down, or most of the towers down, so many immortals become options. Lane now, Miranda, she's thrown out. He did. Not sure if it landed. Oh, it did land on the spin. Oh, it's next. The rabbit is going to get dropped by the stars from elsewhere. The Doom, the fight is split, dies. But that is a very, very worthwhile trade for E-Home. Old Chicken, consistent in the mid lane, as I said before, to say the least, is going to end up tagging a Sven with a free-handed arrow. It really doesn't get that much better than that, honestly. And now he has the double Star Storm with that Aghanim Scepter, and now they have another target in their sight. It's Q, who has a TP scroll, but I'm pretty sure the Chronosphere reserved for him. Yeah, there it is. I was like, is that a first hit? No, it's a Chronosphere. Ice's Ice is too far away to hit him, but Old Chicken is certainly not. Another kill here for Ehome. Unfortunately, kind of unfortunately for them, it's kills in the bottom lane. So, you know, there's no real way to capitalize off of this. Still going for Roshan is kind of risky, but the last is the Elder is happening as well as there. They have a lot of support for though, so they're going to try to run down before he decks to rush. So here comes the spooky Elder Knight Ghost. Gotta respect. Oh, man. He gets put to sleep. Gonna try to rotate in. Like, get interrupted. Go in the classroom. Try to go in. Try to get end up on the high ground. No one's able to jump in and steal this whole 11 gravity. And now Super stuck on the high ground. He's gonna get demolished by the defusing. Boom. Okay. Well, he's got the Aegis with me. No more access. Brings me home. Can push forward with absolutely everyone. Yeah. Is gonna be able to come by the plane. Will fly over the trees. Old 11 is going not to have a weapon for Rabbit. Kills him off. Still, Fenrir in the back with Ice, not really able to fire all that much. Now, C-Deck able to split up the fight, chip down an Elo. We're actually going to take a reasonable walk. Crash is going to get yet another Echo Saber hit. Multiple heroes, hammer on the city with Fenrir. He's going to land him in the meantime, fighting up against him. Despite the flame deck, still doing a lot of work. But eventually, all Ice is coming up with a line in exchange. It's only the Crystal Man who somehow arrived to last. The survival of the Elo spot, but the Timber's not on the chase. Blood surviving this Fenrir. Could be a triple kill for Super and Stick. It looks very bad for them because they wasted absolutely everything on someone with an Aegis, and that's never really what you want to be doing. But this environment for C-Deck was so much better than it was for Ehome because the Clinks, the Mirana, and like, if you want to get up, you really commit yourself up to this high ground. With C-Deck, they have the high ground. They are able to, you know, play around it a little bit more since they have the Batrider with that Blink Dagger and, of course, Radiant's Timbersaw. And Ehome, we're kind of sitting in the Firefly the entire time, taking a lot of low burn damage. Super's gonna get Chronosphere. There is an arrow coming in from Old Chicken. Double Star Storm. Is that enough to instantly get the kill? Well, it will be. Aces Void gonna grab the last hit there. Did not see the Chronosphere in that last fight. Old 11 got fingered for his first life. And then I'm pretty sure Sven just God strength him down 100-0 for the second life. Ehome are in a pretty good fight. Look, pretty strong good position. However, the difference is that even though they down the Aegis, Ehome still get the road off that. What happens like over here or over here, then Ehome will have a vast advantage. Just, you know, by virtue of their. And they're really just kite around the Sven. Hard to kite around the Sven in this area when Sven is, you know, in melee range of everyone at any given time. Yao is gonna take to the skies. I'm not sure if there's an angle here for anyone, really. This is... That's spotted by... You know, he was smoked up. I don't think this was the... Ehome don't have any observer wards anywhere. Radiant's middle tower. This is not a Radiant observer ward. It is definitely not. Yeah, they didn't see it. Star Sense, though. Over the top with Ice. Is gonna spot the rabbit. Double invis! How do you see them? I'm gonna invis all the way from mid. Smoke up as well. Ice already scouting their target in the Sven. They don't know exactly who's here. We'll see a courier, maybe. That's a nice tip, I guess. That's it. I think Deck might have seen all of this. It started with Moonlight Shadow. You can't see this in about this range, though. Yeah, I think this was spot on. They smoked up a little bit late. They picked up, smoked, then did everything else. I should have been at least a chance for death. The big deal, Ehome still able to apply this pressure because of how easy it is for them to push waves with this Mirana. How easy it is for them to get kills. We've already seen Faceless Void and Mirana team up to get pretty much a dual kill on Timbersaw, who's supposed to be tanky, but definitely not tanky enough. And we haven't really seen Ice Ice snipe anyone out just yet, or, recently. But we can still see him do that in the near future. Like, Lion was 3-shot last time. Not sure if it's gonna stay 3-shot in this game. Might get to 2-shot. Who knows? But another tower down, which is of course going to open up an entirely new can of worms for C-Deck. Losing more map control, it means that you need to spend all the more in sentries and whatnot to kind of soft counter the Claims, Shadowblade, and Moonlight Shadows and Mirana. Things are getting a lot more difficult for C-Deck as they lose map control, even in a less farm space as well. Now, to Rabbit's credit, he's still farming pretty darn well. BKB is almost up on him. They're going to try to bait out a reactor at tier 1 bottom, but Ehome are going to gladly sack a tier 1. And they should gladly sacrifice a tier 1 to grab a tier 2 on top. Rabbit's here. Maybe Ehome keeps alone? I don't know. It seems like kind of a noobish assumption if Ehome decides to do that. And there's no reason to, right? See, no one on the top lane. You got sentries. You're not spotted. Almost perfect intel. Ice is tier south. Tier 1 for tier 2. Steve cannot race Ehome here, not by any means. So I guess C-Deck get a tower, get a BKB. This Sven is going to have to do some serious work with it. He's doomed beforehand, though. Not able to get his God Strength off for whatever reason. Chronosphered or arrowed or anything, really. Then the fight for C-Deck is pretty much just done and they can't win. This Sven needs to stay not crowd controlled. But again, like, BKB is only kind of half your turn in this game. Especially if a Diffusal Blade ever comes up. 11 not gonna go for that, even though I thought he was going to. Mirana not quite there yet either. Got Moonlight Shadow under a sentry, but the sentry of course can't see anything because sentries are blind. Moonlight Shadow again is going to be unsuccessful. Fenrir, yeah, is gonna show it off over in mid. I guess C-Deck haven't died, but it's really not about getting killed as C-Deck, that's really the backbreaking thing. It's the fact that they're losing farm space because they're scared of what someone can do to them with all these towers down. All justifiably so. Losing farm space, able to consistently get out on map without smoking. Have, you know, some amount of those. So, you know, have the run of the map, have the kill power, and sooner or later, they will look for Roche. I didn't get hung up, but that's the grand plan here for home. Use this map control to get all the farm on all the heroes. Lock C-Deck into just farming up their Sven. So, you know, Timbersaw has got travels, got stone. I don't know when he last got the travels. I want to say it was like 18 minutes, but either way, he's not going to have any follow-up item for a very long time. Which for Ehome will be, hey, you know, just flooded with items. Is under attack. I mean, they don't even flood with items, honestly. Like, Base Void, as soon as he gets his BKB, does not need anything else. Of course, we'd love to get that Shadowblade upgrade versus the Timbersaw. That would be pretty sweet if you can get that going. Or Diffusal, or Mantastyle, or, you know, anything else. So it's just a slow map control game for Ehome, and I'm pretty sure we're gonna see this reflected in the net worth. Not really to a substantial degree. Ehome's, yeah, grouped up their own jungle, actually, respecting the C-Deck pickoff power. Blink Dagger on any of these heroes? There's one on the Sven, so he's able to join the fights very quickly, and the Sven is someone they have to respect a lot. But you would expect Ehome to be just winning by this path of game state, simply because they farm faster and in more places for C-Deck to make rotations like this instead of pushing this tower as they would probably like to in any ordinary situation. Can't really afford to. At least they can't afford to. It'd be very, very risky. Leave Claims on your high ground for like 2-3 seconds and suddenly your tower is dead. Oh god, perfect world, please! Please be more perfect, or at least not terrible sometimes. At least we got last game, right? We'll always have C-Deck versus Tongfu. Wow, Ehome are very, very scared, actually. I mean, they don't see anyone on C-Deck, so that's really why they're making this move. They're assuming C-Deck are smoked, which I guess kind of nice for C-Deck, since they're not, obviously. BKB on the Faceless Void, still nothing really substantial on this Mirana just yet. Isis Ice as well. 2k gold into BKB, Desolator, nothing yet. But here we go, Ehome gonna take a smoke break. Who's going to be the unlucky target, if any? C-Deck are pretty well positioned for this, honestly, with Q and a choke point, Rabbit able to blink in, plus absorbed sentry coverage. Faceless Void in a lost high ground flying into Rabbit Dome. Or you're not gonna get it. You get back up. Get the net as well. Now Rabbit has time trap and jump in. And then solid point. That's already a kill, but this is doomed at point with Clink bearing down him. Trying to do what he can for Steven, but Farmlet not doing nearly enough. Now super in a lot of trouble. Vice is just standing his ground, killing off anyone he can find. Hardy's gonna say, screw this, I'm leaving. Yao, though, he's caught in a corner. He has a force attack, but that's not gonna get him down to the low ground. Ulting in over blinks, but it doesn't matter because Yao's stuck is gonna give up the gem. It's a triple kill for Ice, and that was a Chronosphere-less fight for EHOME. Their Faceless Void didn't do anything, in fact. Didn't even use his BKB because he was just dead so quickly. But for EHOME, they're able to look out the Sven. At this point, the Sven really is the only significant threat that C-Deck has. And as long as you're able to split up enough so that you don't get cleaved by him, the Doom on him, and start picking at him from multiple range angles. And this Sven is just incredibly awkward. He killed the Faceless Void incredibly easy, but that's not gonna do it. That's not gonna win you a fight. Gotta be able to kill off the Clinks, gotta kill off the Morana straight afterwards, and Tursaw, because he hasn't gotten anything else item-wise, is of course in an awkward position as well. No Blood Zone charges gained in this game, I don't think, like, at all. Now Roche, the Desolator, with the right clicks from Ult Chicken and Ice both. Claim a pretty easy double life. At the same time, have Chronosphere coverage just in case. Stomp, he's gonna land it, don't land him. Putting Roche to sleep as well. Dagger on line. I think they should be able to avoid that. Chronosphere is gonna catch them on the edge, guaranteeing the double life, and now Olaf is gonna jump in with a BKB, just trying to drive everyone away by him. Letting him leave the pit, maybe. Ice, and Old Chicken call it two-man hammer, though. Rabbit's gonna start cleaving through, take down the Aegis, but fails to stop the Clink. Meantime, Lion been assassinated in backline. His voids still cause problems here for the C-Deck squad. Though he is completely out of mana, he will shadow play it out. They get the gem. Their dust up. Did that catch him? Oh, he is caught with the dust, but they're not gonna push forward. And EHOME, they really only lose the Aegis for that. That does kind of suck because now they can't make an aggressive high ground push, but they are still able to keep everyone alive where it counts. When you're forced to use such defensive Chronosphere, you really hope just to minimize casualties. Plus, they didn't have Doom on cooldown from the last fight, so in just a minute, they will have both the Doom and the Chronosphere. Maybe a new item, Lincoln Sphere on the Mirana, will keep her safe versus that Hammer next time. That is completed now. And Clink's yet 2,000 gold, now he's got the crit, and he's looking at a Daedalus real soon. So EHOME, let's say, break even in the fight, even if they do get a real kill. But he just didn't really matter all that much. We'll still be able to apply this pressure across the map, and EHOME, they might have a vulnerable target here in Yao. Link Dagger staff, no doom though, so if Scythe rotates in, that pattern has to sense something coming. Very far away though, and he unfortunately didn't go right around this corner to see the Firefly. Not gonna see the bat. Top lane jungle is dead zone. The deck are pushing them bot. Which is incidentally where you are not. Clink, he has BKB as crit. He can BKB the Lion, like, be really easy and keep dead now. And he's back. He's by sucks. And he's dead. No, he comes back. Okay. Oh, the suspenseful perfect world lag. Never gonna happen. Thought he was just dead. But no, straight TP, hex TP rather. To get the Lion out of there. For sure. I don't really want to use the BKB charge for a Lion anyway. So just a quick snapshot. And that victory was nice. I'm sure. See, now the net worth is slowly starting to creep upwards in there. Having a safe game that is very just a farm style. Smoke? Now, oh, that was not smoke. Moonlight Shadow. Run to a smoke from Stek. Yao's in the front. Target, old Levin, Chronosphere, not too sad, he does get a BKB. Chronosphere can land only at the Q. The Lion, stop and rat. He's found his way onto old man. Well, not down. Doom to the taking pot. Well, absolutely no in the meantime. Oh man, this lost with the C-Deck. They're lost. They're looking his way out to the target of focus. The one that you had to kill off in the last. Doesn't matter who it is, if the hero is last, you should be is going at the dude a little bit too tanky. The follow just not there. And Sven is not quite fast enough to actually catch up to and keep hitting these targets. And Rana is constantly tanking at it with a ton of damage to the Rana, but enough. Plank is pushing a little bit more, and now gonna try to go for super ult, getting a pounce and movement speed buff. Not quite enough to get you close to a Timbersaw. They can afford to let him go because they saw that. Maybe they no TP right now, but he's been for all that matters. They frostbite. Yao, is he dead now? No, he's just taking a lot of damage. Or though, he's very dead. Ult 7 caught Glimmer Cape, getting a little bit of safe. Star Jumper Super, thinking got the kill there. Yes, he's dead. And Old Land is chasing in. Armlet Spoon, Fearless. No, I out. We'll take the entirety mid lane. Radiant's retreat. They're lost. Nothing. They lose anyone there. I don't think they lose anyone there, actually. Use their ult, use their BKBs, but that's what they're there for. C-Deck, they are kind of helpless. And you know, they're actually able to get that on the Sen. This is gonna get you home that round of items. I don't know if anything on the flings by the time they want to go for that. Chin's got it. Well, all the cash. Bane, not with any. You have a look coming up on the dude. And a Maelstrom on the point. Sure, whatever floats boat. There's some way to get around the armor deck. It's just go mad. In. Oh, Guardian. Into that. That could be dangerous. But Eho, they have another round of items, whereas for C-Deck, they have very little. Dual Timber Saw and the Clink, yes. It's not pretty, but he died in the end. They have smoke. I'm out of really smoke. And they're gonna go into the jump with the targets aplenty. For a Q or their painter size and go for the Sven. Just for the Sven. I feel despite being very low mana, it seems like they're gonna go for the eater. They know where they are. Guardian 1, 2, 3 shots. Well, he's gonna try to ghost step for himself. They caught super with the Glimmer. That's my umbrella kill. Will he scored turns? It was Marvel Spear. He's able to quite old land. They land boom in time. So Chronosphere is usually used just for the Elf Titan there. It's actually at that. See that? But you know, it's still lose Kiro. Not the guy there. Yo, wait for another. They look for that exact same play pretty much forever. At this point, though, like their mana is actually hurting them quite a bit. Even though Fenrir has maxed out his aura, has gotten that max out a long time ago. Like, Void is not what I would call a star hero. Klinks is not bright either. Now we're gonna go into the mountain, so Klinks has more than enough mana to get to a brawl. It's like hell, he's forced to use BKB and run away. He's not gonna die in fact, Fenrir. Yes, jumped on by Yash. I was coming up across by taking a lot of damage to the Farstar Wolf. Now here comes Old Land. Get the out with the arrow sneak in. They'll grab the kill there and he's gonna call it. GG Ehome absolutely thrashed C-Deck. There really wasn't any full game where Ehome significant hit. Damage done, but there were near enough to win that game for C-Deck. It has lanes. C-Deck, but they constantly got rid of them.